Hi there, I'm doing this video for my students at Udemy and the rest of you who want to learn React or get better at React programming. What I teach is chatbots and Google Assistant and JavaScript and much more. And some of my courses use React. So the students were reaching out to me asking me how can I get better at React, how can I learn more. So I decided to do this video for you. React is gaining popularity. Just look at this. I checked the NPM downloads. I compared React, Vue, and Angular downloads in the last year. As you can see, React is leading by all means. Also, if we check Google Trends, we can see that no doubt React is the most popular one. So, if I wanted to learn React or I wanted to get better at it, where would I go? There are quite a lot of free tutorials that I think are quite good out there. But the fastest and the best way to learn a new language and skill is, in my opinion, to take an excellent course or maybe even two and learn from there. In a course, you have structured content. It is not scattered all over YouTube and articles and everywhere. So when I want to learn a new thing, I take a course. Even after 20 years of development, I still take courses. I find it easier and most effective. I'm raising a small child, so I need to be effective. And I wanna be. In the last few years, we have seen a flood of courses. You might be asking, which one is the best one for me? So in this video, I'm going to explore React courses, and I'm gonna show you which one I choose as the best and why. So what is my criteria? Well, the first thing is the course content. In my opinion, a good React course should cover the React basics, function and class components, state handling, and React router. And also advanced features like Redux, when and how to use it. I say when because Redux is not always the way to go. It can be an overkill for many apps. Then Redux Saga, hooks and contexts. It should show you how to connect to an API. And it should teach you how to test the application and how to make good architectural decisions, so you are not afraid of creating bigger apps. It should show you good design practices. And yes, it could also show you how to interact with other tools like GraphQL. The course also should cover toolchains supporting React, including NPM, Webpack, Babel, and cutting-edge EA6, EA7 JavaScript. So yes, this is what I would want from the content. I'm a demanding, knowledge-seeking student, and I want the best in my courses. I'm willing to pay the price. Although we all know, if we wait long enough on Udemy, sooner or later, there will be an excellent promotion, maybe even for $9, which is the lowest you can get on Udemy. So, what did I take as another criteria? The first one is the content. What does it include and how it is structured? Since my first course, the ones I took as a student and a few I made of my own, I have learned how important it is that the course is well structured. If the content is not organized in a manageable way, then it just confuses me. So, the next one would be how the instructor is presenting the course. Does the instructor speak in a way I can understand him? Or does he go and ramble something to himself and copy-paste code, so I cannot understand a word? I like if the instructor knows I'm new at this and clearly shows me. Sometimes showing me something in a different way so that I can understand. I like to understand not just how, but also the why. An excellent instructor knows how to do so. And one more thing, he makes it fun. I like instructors who are clear when explaining, but also have a sense of humor. A touch of humor and an easygoing instructor make it manageable for me. Come on, who can listen to 40 hours of content if the instructor is dull and never makes a joke or does something funny? I can't. So, what did I say so far? I take a look at the content and its structure. I check out the instructor, his or her references, and the way of presenting the material. I take a look if there are any challenges. Having Git commits with the code changes is a big plus for me. Maybe some takeaways are also good. And yes, of course, I check what other people are saying about the course. I check the reviews and the ratings of the course. Are you ready to check out the courses? Let's dive in! At this moment, there are 173 courses with the topic of React. Ouch! Yes, you heard me right, 173 courses. Of course, I did not check all of them. I looked at the first 10, then decided to look deeper into the selection of 3 and pick out the winner, or 2 among them. So, what courses did I pick up first? The first one is Andrei's course. You know, I don't know how to pronounce it, his last name. Neagoie, oh my god. I'm sorry, I don't know how. But don't be afraid, his English is far better than mine. The course title is Complete React Developer in 2020. It includes Redux, hooks and also GraphQL, which is a great tool for fetching data on your front-end apps. The course explains the basics and dives into advanced topics quite quickly. I like that in the course we built one big application, which is an online e-commerce store. And we do also implement Stripe payments, use Firebase, GraphQL. So a few topics other courses might not have. The pros of this concept are that you have a large-scale app to show at the end, and you know the concepts behind such an app. The cons, I would say, is that the course does not explain why using Redux would be an overkill for many applications. And what I also like about this course is that it has a pretty active community behind it. And creators post challenges and make things fun. Like right now, they started a new challenge, an advent of code, one change per day for 25 days. Pretty cool. Also, the delivery is great. Andrei speaks clearly, explains the concepts behind. The whys. But the instructors are not answering the Q&A of the course. But as I said, they have a community on Concord that is live and you can reach instructors there. Also, they have great bonus lessons. In a bonus lessons, you can find progressive web apps, Firebase security, testing with Jest, enzyme and snapshot testing. He talks about the toolkit, Webpack and Babel. And in one bonus section, they show us how to create a Gatsby static block. By taking this course, you will go beyond the basics. Oh yes, and one optional thing. They invite you to select a programming buddy. Somebody who is starting just like you. So you have someone to keep each other accountable throughout the course and motivating each other to finish. I find this to be a great idea. Therefore, I would still rate this course a 5-star course. It's a great experience and I'm almost throughout the course. I'm going through the Gatsby part. Okay, the next one in the bucket of 3 is Cold Steel course, called the Modern React Bootcamp. What I like about Colt Steel is that all that he teaches online comes from teaching in person too. So he has a lot of experience with in-person interaction and he knows what students would ask and what problems they would encounter. So his curriculum is carefully crafted and his teaching style is easy to follow and apply. The course also covers hooks and context besides the basics. What I like about this course is that we make fun projects, games, where he explains the concepts, the why. The apps are a nice add-on for the portfolio. But we also create one massive app that is quite impressive, and in it we use all the learned knowledge. But we don't use Redux. And he explains why in one of his answers very well. He says this about the hooks. Hooks are definitely a big game changer. Your code becomes much clearer and easier to understand. I'm a big fan. I considered teaching this entire course using hooks so that I could market it using all the buzzwords and hopefully stand out compared to other existing React courses and catching on the hooks hype. But in the end, I decided it would be actually best for my students. Hooks are going to take over the entire React world one day. But at the moment, almost all large React apps are written using class-based components. I don't know a single professional React developer who uses hooks on their company's production app. And regarding Redux? As far as Redux, I have a lot of thoughts on that. Redux is a great tool, but I hate how in so many students' minds you can't fully learn React unless you learn React at the same time. I debated back and forth about including Redux in this course. And here? I'm also not a fan of how many courses jump straight to Redux after working through the basics of React. Redux is great. I just don't agree with it being thought as the one way of writing React apps. When I teach React in person, we wait a few weeks before touching Redux rather than diving into it right away. When we finally go to Redux, we actually use a fork of a giant production application. So, my point here is, even if he is not teaching React, this is a great course, and I had given it without a doubt a 5-star rating. One con would be that there are not many answers from him or his assistants in a Q&A of the course. I can understand with such massive sales he has. But still, he was talking about hiring assistants, but I did not see many answers in the Q&A happening. Therefore, by taking this course, you will have a solid foundation and you will know how to develop large-scale apps. You will be a great React developer and you will be confident to start working for any client. So now, a tough choice, the third place. I had three great instructors I absolutely admire and look up to choose from. One would be Maximilian Schwarzmüller. The next one, Steven Grinder, and the last one, Andrew Mead. I like Andrew Mead because he puts a lot of challenges, and his way of speaking is enthusiastic and bright. And I love Steven Grinder because he knows how to structure content, and his course focuses more on Redux and goes into depth. And then Maximilian's course. Maximilian has all the topics we are looking for, the basics, router, hooks, Redux, React routing, animations, Neagoie.js, and so on. He has also a lot of resources free on YouTube. Maybe you can check there first to see his style. He updates the course and he organizes course in a logical manner. So for these reasons, I would put him in the third place. He has a personal touch that I like. He speaks like a friend throughout his videos, which makes it nice and you get a feeling you can do it. And his German accent is not really that bad. You know, I know how much work there is to make a good course. You never know until you try to make one. And all these five instructors are not good. They are great. When I wanted to refresh my knowledge of React, I had a hard time deciding. So, if I were you, I would buy the Andrei's course, Complete React Developer in 2020, and Cold Steel course, Modern React Bootcamp. I loved both courses and recommend them to all of my students. Maximilian's course I added to the third place, and Steven comes fourth. Down here are the links to the winning courses. I get a super small provision if you buy from these links. I hope my decision process helped you in any way. As said, I made a decision based on the content, teaching style, shared resources and reviews of the course. If any of these five instructors resonate more with you, you will not go wrong. These are all great courses, so dive in and become React Master. And by the way, if you look in the reviews, you will see many of these students get jobs and start working on great projects. So can you. I hope I made it easier for you. If you want me to check out any other courses for you, let me know. And if you want to learn about chatbots and Google Assistant apps, check out my courses. Links are down below. Have a great day. Bye-bye.